Hello friends, Ecovation brings to you the newspaper editorial analysis of the Hindu newspaper for 3rd May. If you want this analysis in Hindi, you can find the link in the description below. If you are looking for the analysis of the Indian Express newspaper, you can also find that link in the description below. I am Apurv Mishra and these are my credentials. You can connect to me over the Ecovation app by joining my study group. This is the link which you can find in the description below. You can email me your queries by writing to me at apurv@ecovation.com, and you can also connect to me over Facebook. So let us look at today's newspaper. The first page, the first article of the opinion, in the opinion column, it is in the context of the Kashmir situation, which is deteriorating day by day. So it is related to your syllabus, especially to GS paper 3, the internal security portion. The specific syllabus points are linkages between development and spread of extremism, even the role of external state and non-state actors in creating challenges to internal security becomes relevant here, because Pakistan is the external state actor which is instigating militancy in Kashmir, and also the role of social networking sites. So recently, the spread of militancy is being instigated more through social networking sites than through direct modes, as was being done previously. So what are the issues here? The article talks about this newly born concept of unattached militant who is not Pakistan sponsored directly as per se, but who has borne out because of a sense of anger. And that anger has emerged because of the issues of development. So the youth does not have sufficient jobs in Kashmir today, and the infrastructure also is not as good as it should be. Not only the physical infrastructure, but the social infrastructure, including health services, education services as well. And also there is anger related to the flood rehabilitation, the rehabilitation which happened after the 2014 Srinagar floods. So these are all the issues which led development issues which got mixed with the issues of democracy. So the youth today of Kashmir has lost faith in elected leadership, and it has also lost faith in the separatist leadership. So that's why it has started to turn towards violent militancy. And it is looking towards leaders like Burhan Wani, and it is after his execution that the situation has really blown off. So also the role of social media has been very critical in making the situation what it is today. So earlier, while Pakistan used to push in jihadis across the border, today instead of pushing its own jihadis, what Pakistan is doing is it has maintained its own cyber warfare cell, and all of them are trying to spread their propaganda across the border without actually doing moving physically. So this is also a very low cost strategy for Pakistan and a very huge challenge for India, because there is no way to actually really prove that this thing is happening. So what are the questions which could come out of all this issue and this article? These are the two questions. You can just pause the video and look at the questions and try to write an answer to these questions in about 200 words. Now moving on to the next article. This is in the context of fortification standards which have been recently introduced by FSSAI. FSSAI is the food regulator of India, by the way. So the syllabus links are the GS paper 2, which is in related to the governance and social justice portion, specifically related to the poverty and hunger syllabus point. In the GS paper 3, the science and technology portion can be linked to this article. This is the particular specific syllabus point, development and their applications and effects in everyday life. So what is the concept of fortification? It is the process of adding micronutrients to the food. So the point, micronutrients is very critical here. These micronutrients lead to a number of deficiency disease. Micronutrients are different from macronutrients. You should remember them. So macronutrients are those which are required in large quantities, like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, while micronutrients are vitamins, minerals, which are required in very small quantities, but their deficiency leads to a number of diseases. So iron, vitamin A and iodine are three critical micronutrients whose deficiency is being registered in 1/3 of the population globally as per WHO. So maternal health and child health are specifically the two points which are really impacted by the deficiency of micronutrients. So fortification of food by micronutrient can be used to really tackle these major issues of maternal health and child health across the world. So what are the issues related to this new policy of food fortification? The two major issues are availability and affordability. So availability means actually making that fortified food available to every person across the country, while affordability talks about making it available at a price at which even the poorest of the poor could actually get those fortified food. So what is the strategy of the government? So local flour mills would be used, and PDS could also be used to provide affordable access to fortified food. So this article also talks about the point that fortified food is only a short-term stopgap solution. It cannot be a long-term solution. So in the long term, a diversified wholesome diet needs to be provided to the whole population to actually keep this health sustainable. So this is the question which I think could be asked related to this topic. So just pause this video, note down this question, and try to write its answer in around 200 words. Now, this article is in the context of Erdogan, who is the president of Turkey, his visit to India. So this article is not very important for us. You can give it a quick read. Let me elaborate on this particular point, that even though bilateral relations with other countries is important for your syllabus, but you get only 4 to 5 questions related to international relations in your exam, and there are normally much more important 4-5 points related to questions of US, China and all. Relations with Turkey are a very minor issue, and I do not expect you to get a question out of it. So just give it a quick read so that you know what all has happened, but don't spend too much time on it. Now, coming to this article, Refuge from the Sinking Islands. This is in the context of the low-lying islands in the Pacific and the Indian Ocean specifically, which are bound to sink due to climate change. So this will lead to a large-scale migration from these of the inhabitants of these islands. And this article talks about the issues which would be associated with adaptation. So I'll talk a bit more about it in a while. This article is related to your syllabus, specifically with GS paper 1 geography, changes in critical geographical features and the effect of such changes. Also to your GS paper 2 international relations portion, global agreements involving India. So Paris Agreement is the backdrop of this whole article and discussion. So the concept of adaptation is that it talks about the changes in policies and lifestyles needed, which need to be made as per the changed climate. A similar concept is mitigation, which generally comes up in these diplomacy and negotiations. Mitigation is all those strategies which are employed for preventing and slowing down climate change, like stopping or cutting down the carbon dioxide emissions. So it will prevent climate change from happening in the first place. While adaptation is once the change has happened, now what we can do to adapt to this change. Now, what are the issues which this article talks about? It talks about those low-lying island countries who would be the first victims of climate change, even though they produce very little greenhouse gases and are the least culprit. They would be the first victims. So, and these islands are bound to submerge, and the whole populations of these islands would get displaced and need to be rehabilitated to other places, to other countries. So the issue is that international community is not realizing and not exceeding its responsibility, because the cost of such displacement would be huge on the countries which would be hosting these migrants. So this is a very complex issue, and this article talks about what could be done to solve this problem. It suggests an international forum. Please go through the article. I have highlighted the important points. Here you can see the highlights within the news article. So I think this is one of the question which could be asked. You just read it and pause the video, read it, and try to write an answer to this question in about 200 words. Now, coming to the second page, this article is an interview with ex-president of Afghanistan, Hamid Karzai. Mostly this article is not useful to you, so just give it a quick read, but you could see the last paragraph I have highlighted. So this is an important point for you. This is something which would keep coming up, that what should be the new policy or the change policy of India towards Afghanistan. A more closer engagement is needed. US is also pushing India. So should it mean more soldiers on ground? So Hamid Karzai talks about it. Please read this particular paragraph a bit carefully. Now, this article is about HIV policy India has recently changed. So the ART treatment, which is the antiretroviral treatment, this policy has been changed by India recently and aligned it with WHO guidelines, which says that ART should be provided to every person infected and diagnosed with HIV, irrespective of the CD4 count. CD4 is a type of white blood cell, which is a bit technical. You don't need to go a lot there. So let us see what are the syllabus links. It is linked to your GS paper 2, Governance and Social Justice. Issues related to development and management of health, management of social sectors, health. This is the syllabus link. Also related to your GS paper 3, Science and Technology. And it can be important for your GS prelims as well, this particular article. So just go through the facts carefully. And so this article talks about the challenges about which would come up with this changed ART policy. First of all, there are people who are diagnosed with HIV, but they are not on treatment. So how to actually bring those on treatment and providing them ART? And there are also 500,000 people who are not infected with HIV, but they are never diagnosed. So how to reach out to those people? So these are the challenges related to HIV. And one important concept which I would like you all to know, that there is a slight difference between HIV and AIDS. So there could be people who are infected with HIV, but they do not still have AIDS. So you could, if you are interested, you could read up more on it. In this video, we will move forward with that. So this is the question which I think could, there's one sample question which could come related to this article. Just pause the video, read the question, and try to write an answer for this. Now, this article is, you can just quickly read this concept. This article is not useful for you. Now, coming to this data point, this is in the context of the large number of PILs in the country and the very low acceptance rates, which is in the range of one. Less than 1 to less than 2%. So this graph just shows that you can just look at this data, get a feel of the numbers crudely, and you could use this data in writing an answer which is related to the pros and cons of PILs or assessing the success of PILs in the country. So, and the syllabus link obviously is GS paper 2 Polity Judiciary. So this was all about the newspaper for today, The Hindu. If you think this video was useful to you, please like this video. If you think it could be beneficial to your friends, please share this video on Facebook and WhatsApp. And if you want to get daily updates of these videos, subscribe. You can get more discussions on all these articles and the questions I have told you. You can get free mock tests as well as analysis of these mock tests by joining my study group on Ecovation. Here is the link. You can find it in the description. Thank you very much.